In this closer look, we'll explore how to calculate the average atomic mass of elements. Atoms of the same element can have different numbers of neutrons. When they do, they're called isotopes. And the variation in the number of particles in the nucleus means that the masses of atoms for a particular element will be different depending on the type of isotope that's present. So, when dealing with the masses of atoms, scientists need to know the average atomic mass for a given element. And that's what we'll be practicing calculating in this video. In our first practice problem, let's calculate the average atomic mass of copper. We know that copper has two isotopes. First is copper 63. Of all of the copper in the world, 69.17% is copper 63. And that mass number is rounded up from the more accurate figure of 62.9296 AMU, or atomic mass units. The other isotope of copper is copper 65, which has an abundance of 30.83% and a mass of 65. This mass number is rounded up from the more accurate number of 64.9278 AMU. To find the average atomic mass, we use these relative percentages of their abundances, multiplying them by the exact mass of the isotopes. Here's the equation that will help us with these calculations. We'll take the mass of the isotope times the abundance in decimal form. So the first isotope that we're dealing with is copper 63, whose exact mass is 62.9296 AMU. We take that mass and we multiply it by the relative abundance, which we saw as a percentage. But remember, we want it in decimal form. We can always convert a percentage to decimal form by simply dividing that percentage by 100. And a shortcut for doing that division is simply moving the decimal two places to the left. So we take the 69.17% and rewrite it as 0.6917, and then multiply that times the exact mass of the isotope, 62.9296 AMU. That gives us 43.5284. We do the same thing with the next isotope, copper 65. We take the exact mass, which is 64.9278 AMU, and we multiply it by the percent abundance, 30.83%, which we write in decimal form as 0.3083. That gives us 20.0172. At this point, we have the mass contribution from each of the two isotopes as far as the overall average atomic mass for copper. So if we add these two values together, 43.5284 plus 20.0172, we get 63.5456 AMU. And that's the average atomic mass for copper. To recap, this comes from the sum in the equation. So for both isotopes, we took the mass of those isotopes times the abundance in decimal form, and then we added those two values together. We could do the same thing if there were three or more known isotopes for a particular element. For instance, let's do another calculation of average atomic mass, this time for magnesium, which has three known isotopes. They are magnesium-24, which has a mass of 23.9850 and an abundance of 78.99%, magnesium-25, with a mass of 24.9858 and an abundance of 10.00%, and magnesium-26, with a mass of 25.9826 and an abundance of 11.01%. Let's use the same equation to determine the average atomic mass. The overall sum of the exact mass of isotopes times their abundance in decimal form, and we'll take the same steps we used before. We take the mass of the first isotope, magnesium-24, which is 23.9850 AMU, and multiply it times its abundance, converted to decimal form, which is 0.7899, and that equals 18.9458. We do the same thing for the second isotope, magnesium-25, with a mass of 24.9858 AMU, so that's 24.9858 times 0.1000, which is the abundance of 10% in decimal form, and that gives us 2.4986. For the third isotope, magnesium-26, with a mass of 25.9826 AMU, we take 25.9826 times the percent abundance in decimal form, which is 0.1101, and we get 2.8607. To get the average atomic mass of magnesium, we add the mass contributions of each of the three individual isotopes to the overall average. 18.9458 plus 2.4986 plus 2.8607, and we get 24.3051. And that's the average atomic mass of magnesium in AMU. Here's one for you to try. I'll give you the problem, and you press pause and solve it. Then hit play and see if you got the right answer. Here's the problem. Almost all neon occurs naturally in two major isotopes, neon 20 with an atomic mass of 19.992 AMU, and neon 22 with an atomic mass of 21.991 AMU. What is the average atomic mass of neon? Now press pause. Okay, let's see if you got it right. If your answer was 20.18 AMU, that is correct. If not, here's a refresher on how we get there. We take the exact mass times the abundance for each isotope. We get 18.097 for the mass contribution from neon 20, and 2.08 was the mass contribution from neon 22. And when we take those two numbers and add them together, we get the average atomic mass for neon, which is 20.18 AMU. That's a closer look at average atomic mass. For more Chemistry Matters, visit our homepage, where the entire series is available to you.